Now, a lot of people are going to say, well, I don't like this message, Dimcad. I'm unsubscribing. Well, okay, first of all, if you're unsubscribing, then just go away. I mean, there's no need to really announce it to anybody. And I think by being angry with me, it's sort of like a cop-out, because we have a real problem in this country. And it's the merit system. And instead of people really dealing with the actual problem in this country, they rather blame individuals instead of looking at the actual problem. So this video is going to be a format for people to chat about this very serious problem in America. The fact that the marriage system is not working for men, and there's really no point of a man getting married. So, okay, if you're a young man and you're thinking about getting married, this is a video for you. In this video, I'm going to cover the things that you rarely hear people talking about. I talk about essentially what marriage really is and the consequences of marriage and the complaints I've heard from married men. Now, first, let me eliminate some arguments people will automatically raise. First, people will say, well, if you're religious, a lot of people say that, well, the Bible says this, the Bible says that. Let me eliminate all that by letting you know that there's a difference between religious marriage, which is the marriage between a man and woman before God, and legal marriage, which is a union between a person and a person before the state, okay? Legal, religious. They're not the same thing. When you get married legally, you're signing a contract. It is a financial agreement. Forget about all the nonsense you hear about romance, okay? You're putting yourself in a situation where you are legally obligated to commit yourself to one woman, and if it doesn't work out, you can end up paying financially, and it could be a very severe situation. Now, another thing people say that, oh, well, you know, this argument is sexist and all this stuff. Let me tell you something. Have you ever heard the phrase, absolute power corrupts absolutely? I'm sure you have. That phrase doesn't just apply to men. It applies to women, too. It doesn't matter what your gender is. If you sign a contract that says that you'll only have sex with this one woman, you're giving her extraordinary powers over your life. Essentially, she controls when you have sex and whatever. And a lot of women use that to manipulate you and basically control your life. And it doesn't matter what their gender is. It's not about their gender. It's the fact that they have absolute power over you. So when you sign that contract, you're putting yourself in a very compromising situation. Now, common things you see when you start to hang out with married couples, I recommend that any guy who's considering getting married to spend a few months really, really hanging out with a married couple, different married couples, really getting to know them, and seeing what happens once the woman lets down her guard, and listening to the nagging, the complaining, the constant bitching. Now, let me know that not every woman is like this. It's just that I noticed that virtually all American women who are married that I've encountered behave like this, okay? It's not all. Let me tell you, it's not all, but most are like this. And this is what I hear from other married guys. And yes, there's some really nice married women out there. Mrs. Boatwright, Mrs. D'Angelo, hey, what's up? I've met some, I know for a fact. But they're in the minority, and that's the key right there. I mean, come on, guys. Don't pretend like you don't know what I'm talking about when I'm talking about that pussy whip married guy, friend of yours. You know exactly what I'm talking about. The type of guy who has to beg his wife to leave the house, okay? I'm not making this up. I've seen this many, many times. Oh, man, I don't know. I gotta see what Katie says. You know, I've seen guys beg their wives to go to the corner store or to the movie store, the video store about five blocks away. I'm not playing, okay? Come on, baby, please, please, please. I'm not exaggerating. I'm not. That's what scares me, okay? It's like once a man gets married, he has to get permission from his wife to do anything. It's scary, scary stuff. So even though, yes, I have met some sweet married women, but they're like one out of what? 12 or 13 or so, based on my experience. I mean, come on. It's the other 13 you should be worried about, okay? A lot of people say, well, you gotta make sure you marry the right person. Well, everybody gets married thinks they're gonna marry the right person. I mean, you know, it's like, how do you know you're not just one of the guys who are gonna end up with one of the 13? I mean, come on. I mean, everybody thinks they're gonna marry the right person. You know, I also hear guys say, oh, well, there's no regrets, you know. But it's never really that convincing. I mean, because they all say the exact same thing, and they usually use their kids as a justification for getting married. But see, there's nothing that marriage offers that a man can't already get, okay? A man doesn't need marriage for kids. He can have kids outside of marriage. Now, yes, kids are better off when they have two parents, but however, if the marriage doesn't work out, it's a very traumatic experience for the kids. And plus, by getting married, you're making a sacrifice as a man. So it's still not in your best interest. You're just sacrificing for your kid in hopes that it'll work out. But of course, if it doesn't work out, it'll be a really bad situation for the kid. So you don't need marriage for kids. You don't need marriage for sex. You can obviously get that without marriage. You don't need marriage for companionship. You can obviously get that without marriage. You don't need marriage for friendship. Obviously, you can get that without marriage. People say, oh, you have to have somebody to be with when you're old and have somebody to share the good times and bad times. Well, you can share the good times and bad times with friends and siblings and other family members, you know. And a lot of times when you get married, those marriages don't last anyway. Half the times, they don't last in this country. And when they do last, a lot of those people are absolutely miserable. And they stay together because they don't want to lose their kids or, you know, they don't want to put their kids through any type of trauma or simply because they're just complacent. You know, they're not really happy, but they feel like they'll be even more miserable if they're not with the person. So, you know, it's not the storybook ending that you always hear. And a lot of guys complain that once they get married, the women start to treat them differently. At first, it's, you know, the woman, she's all over him. She's always putting out, always having sex with him, always giving blowjobs. And, you know, she's always saying all these good things about him. But then once they get married and start to have kids, then all of a sudden, you know, he's a loser. He can't do anything right. He's stupid. He's that. He's this. You know, they complain about that. They complain about the way a guy turns and makes left turns, and how the guy fixes peanut butter sandwiches and complain about everything. I've been there. I've seen what happened. And no, I'm not some bitter guy who's been married and been hurt and all that stuff, which is a common argument that you hear from people. They oftentimes try to attack me to distract people from the fact that marriage as an institution is a very, very bad institution. Now, this doesn't mean that some guys don't become assholes when they're married. It's just that by signing the contract, as a man, you're putting yourself in a very compromising situation, a very unnecessary situation. So again, it's not about sexism, it's not about religion. None of that plays a part in legal marriage. Marriage as a whole is something that's absolutely unnecessary for guys. And yes, a lot of women do change after marriage. Or should I say, a lot of women reveal who they really are after marriage. And you can use that to criticize the guys as well. But I'm just saying that, you know, after marriage, if there's a divorce, you're going to be the one paying alimony. You're going to be the one paying out child support, most likely, in most cases. There's always exceptions. And there's been situations where women have lied about their husbands being abusive, just so they can get a restraining order and just so they can get custody of the kids. Yes, do your research. Start hanging out with married couples, not just on a couple of occasions, but like extensively, to the point where they feel comfortable around you. You know, you'll be surprised what you'll hear. And a lot of guys complain that the sex pretty much goes downhill after the first marriage. I think it's more like the kids. I think after that second kid, the woman feels comfortable, and then there's really no need to really do all the things she did to get your attention in the first place. You know, so there's just no reason for a man to get married, and I feel like this video is absolutely necessary. Now, let me talk about something you rarely hear about when people talk about marriage. No-fault divorce. In the 70s, no-fault divorce completely changed what marriage was. What no-fault divorce does is it allows, for example, in the scenario, for a woman to cheat on her husband, file for divorce, get alimony, child support, get primary custody, despite the fact she cheated on her husband. See, that's the whole concept behind no-fault divorce. Now, I'm not saying that most women are going to do that. I'm just saying that even if you take away all the things I said before, a relationship, a romantic relationship, is not destined to last forever. I mean, passion doesn't last forever. Eventually, the passion goes out, and you know, people get bored with one another. I mean, that's just another way of really looking at it. And this is just the flat-out truth. People just get bored with one another. Now, some people say that, well, you know, some people do stay married and they're happy. They're happy forever, just like in the movies. Well, you know what? That is possible. But for every couple that meets that criteria, how many couples pretty much stay together and they're miserable, okay? They hate each other to the day they die. Or couples end up divorced and some guy ends up living in some crappy apartment on the shady side of town in the really, really shady neighborhood. And he only sees his kids once every 2 weeks. I mean, come on. There's a lot more not so happy ending than happy ending. So we have to be realistic. I mean, it's sort of like playing a lottery and say, you know what? Well, somebody's got to win. Yeah, but for every winner, it's going to be like 1,000 losers. And chances are you're going to be one of those losers. I mean, and a lot of people argue that, well, this is what the elite want. This is what the controllers in our society want. They want to break down the family. And by saying you're not going to get married, you're participating, and you're doing exactly what they want. Well, I understand that argument, but think about that argument more carefully. yes, marriage is, they want to, yes, I believe that controllers in our society want to break down marriage and want to break down a family, but they have succeeded in doing so. So it doesn't make any sense for a guy to sign a legal contract that's really bad for him just to fight this phenomenon, because it's already happening. For example, if somebody sabotaged a boat, and I knew that when you look at the engineering of the boat, it was destined to sink. It was destined to fall apart, and it's going from one side of the Atlantic to the other side of the Atlantic. Even though I know that's going on, it wouldn't make any sense for me to get on that boat out of protest against a person who sabotaged the boat. You know, I mean, I could warn people, but people, they don't want to hear it. So, I mean, yeah, I could get on the boat and say, well, I can't let those people scare me into having some fun. But the fact of the matter is, the boat has already been sabotaged. The boat is going down. So you have to decide whether you want to go down with the boat or whether you want to go save your own butt. So, you know, and like I said before, you know, some people say, well, if you haven't been married, you don't, how can you really judge what it is? Well, I mean, you know, I know what? I never jumped into a airplane turbine, but, you know, I know that if I jumped into one of those big turbines, the thing would tear my body up into pieces. You know, it's just common sense, you know. You know, I haven't run into a burning building, but common sense says it's a bad idea. So, you know, you have to really think about what you're getting yourself into. So, until marriage changes in this country, until it's more fair for men, then you're going to see more of a decline in the marriage rates. And rightfully so, because there's absolutely nothing that marriage offers that a man can't already get.